So our second speaker, and with closing remarks, is Dr. Stefan Swartling Peterson. He is a professor of global transformation at Karolinska Institutet, global health, Uppsala University, and a former chief of health at UNICEF. Today he is also a health specialist with UNICEF Sweden. Welcome.
Thank you, Sharon. And it's a pleasure to be with you all on these last of 4 days. Now, I reflected a bit. In 1961, President Kennedy famously committed to putting a man on the moon and bring him back before the end of the century. And in 1969, that was done. And that was something that's actually set out something to do something that you didn't know how to do with resources you didn't have, and it crowded in all of society to solve that problem. Now, 60 years later, I would like to propose that we need a moonshot for sustainable health. That is, health for everyone around the planet, which is sustainable and stays within planetary boundaries. Obviously, controlling infections is a key constituent part of a moonshot for sustainable health today. And just as going to the moon had many parts, I would like to propose three missions to achieve this agenda, controlling infections. And incidentally, these are the same three areas that we concluded on when we analyzed this from UNICEF, where I, in my immediate past job as Global Chief of Health. So I'd like to propose three missions. And the first one is to actually prevent infections. I think the last 1 year has changed a lot of our behavior in terms of how we don't shake hands, how we actually distance ourselves, and so on. And it has prevented a lot of viral as well as bacterial infections. And I think that's evident in the hospital statistics from around the world. But my point is that there are many things we're not doing yet. We are only immunizing 80% of the world's children. That was even before COVID. So one child in five in the world has yet to be immunized against infectious diseases. To me, that's a low-hanging fruit in terms of controlling infections. Similarly, a quarter of the world's schools and health facilities, you can't wash your hands, you can't go to the toilet. I mean, getting basic wash facilities to prevent infections to all health facilities and schools, and ideally homes, seems to be another thing which is so basic about controlling infections. So that's my first mission. The second one is the one Uto Cash proposed on day one. That is sustainable, universal access to effective antimicrobials, antibiotics and beyond. Effective antimicrobials is a global public good, like clean air and a lot of these other things, that we need to fix. We need to transform systems to do this. And this actually means not just tampering around the margin with fixing broken markets. It actually means shaping markets. It means transforming systems. And I think the mess we're in now in the world with the vaccine production against COVID is a good illustration why we need to change the whole market and supply and production mechanism. And in this case, and for us here, I'd like to propose that this is not just about the new shining antibiotics, it's also about the generics, which ran short, as we know, in the initial stages, and where we have very vulnerable supply chains, as we heard from some of the groups here. And thirdly, and maybe most importantly, I want to propose a mission to mobilize people. There's no political will unless there is an electorate and there's people asking for it, and there's a dialogue there. Political will does not really arise in isolation. We need to mobilize people. We need to put a face on these on AMR, because it is this faceless thing, and it's people like us who use funny language. We need to tell the human interest stories here that actually move and shake, that go beyond statistics. And I think that's a challenge to all of us, to stop talking Greek and actually talk human interest and talk real people. And I think we need interested people to push for change, to push their leaders for change, but we also need the established lobby groups to push for this, as we heard from the workshops. The cancer societies need to push for this. The sexual and reproductive health and rights societies that want safe deliveries for mother and baby need to push for this. Aspiring prosthesis recipients like myself for hips and knees need to push for this. We need to change how we communicate here. And I think that's really the theme of this workshop, but we need to take it to heart. So, Sharon here. In conclusion, and inspired by Mariana Mazzucato and her moonshot thinking and the mission thinking, I think we need three missions here. We need to transform systems fundamentally to make this happen so that we can control infections towards sustainable health. I think, as we heard Cass Sunstein say, we need to make the right choices, the easy choices, and not just the easy choices, but the fun choices. And secondly, to Hanan Balki's point here, we need inclusive leadership. We need inspired leadership that goes beyond a couple of the UN organizations to crowd in public, private, me as a private person, and actually make this one of the things that we really strive for. So, as we close off our computers in a bit here, Sharon, and we go home, I want you to think about the Uppsala Health Summit 2021 as the game changer, when you got inspired, energized, and empowered. And I want to propose a slogan that we go home. And I've checked, it's actually available. It is, yes, we can.
Yes, we can. Thank you, Dr. Stefan Swartling Peterson. You will take us to the moon.